Yes, children. So finally, we understood that how women were struggling in the at the time of French Revolution and earlier to that also. Okay, so they did not have any voting rights, political rights. They did not have any access for the education and even for the job training. And they had to struggle a lot because they have to work to lead their life, just to lead their life. Along with that, they have to take care of their entire family. Okay, so these are all the things they were doing. So they thought that only when they pressurize the revolutionary government, they may get some chance for their betterment. So that's the reason they started with some political clubs. Okay, so same like how men were doing, the same way even women started with the political clubs. Okay, around 60 political clubs in the different places they have started. And then what happened? The many women were struggling that, and their main demand was the political equality like men. Okay, how men were having the political rights, the same political rights equal to the men they were expecting. Okay, so the main thing, only when they, you know, get the voting right, only when they enter into the assembly, and only when they hold the political offices, then they thought that their interest will be represented in the new government. So that was their main thought or the idea. So that is the reason they started to demand for the right to vote and to be the part of this elected assembly and to be holding the political office. Okay. See, in the early years, the revolutionary government did introduce laws that helped improve the lives of women. So later what happened in the early years of the revolutionary government? So earlier to this revolutionary government introduced some laws where, you know, the lifestyle of the women can be improved. Okay, it helped the women to lead their life in a better way. What are the facilities that given? So what are the laws that has been framed? Let us see that. See, together with the creation of state schools, schooling was made compulsory for all girls. So finally, so earlier we have seen that what happened? Yes, there was no access to the women to go to school, or there was no access for the education to the women. So finally, here what happened? They created the schools, state schools, but the schooling made compulsory for all the women. So that is very good for all the girls. And then their fathers could no longer force them into marriage against their will. So this is one very much important law they have been framed. Okay, see here. We have seen earlier that only the noble and the prosperous third estate, you know, the daughters, you know, the person's daughters had a access for education only after their marriage has been fixed. But here, that is a reason, you know, their fathers could no longer force them into marriage against their will. If that child or if that girl is not ready to get married, their parents or their fathers should not force them for the marriage. Okay, so only when the child is ready, only when that girl is ready to get married, then only they can approach for the marriage. So that is the one, the one more rule they have been made. And then marriage was made into a contract entered into freely and registered under civil law. So finally, what happened? Yes, the freedom has been given to the even girls also, and it is like a contract entered freely. So the both men and women will be having a contract. So both, if they agree to get married, so then they can get married, and that marriage has to be registered under the civil law. Okay, the marriage has to be registered under the civil law. There is no compulsion. No fathers, you know, the no fathers should be compel their, you know, the children or the daughters to get married till they like. Okay, see here. Divorce was made legal and could be applied for by both men and women. So what happened? What's the meaning of divorced children? So if the, you know, after the marriage, if both men and women, they don't like to live each other. So finally what happened? They can just come out of that relationship. So that has been made legally. So they can just apply for the legal, you know, the notice that is divorce, and they can be separated. And both men and women have a right to apply for this divorce. Okay, if the reason is genuine, any, even men can apply for the divorce or women can apply the divorce. Okay, see, women could now try for jobs, could become, you know, the artists are run small business. So finally what happened? They got an opportunity to study also. The schooling, state schools have been formed and schooling made, you know, the compulsory for the girls. And then the marriages, up to their wish, they have given the freedom for their marriage also, and divorce became legal. And the next thing is the women, for women, now they can get the job training also. They can get job training, they can start their own business, and they can become the artists, anything. They can do whatever they want, and they can start even their small business, the small scale enterprises also they can start. Okay, but see, the women's struggle for equal political rights, however, continued. So finally, what was their main demand, children? I know, along with all these opportunities, what was their main demand? For the political equality like men. Okay, they continued to struggle for that during the reign of terror. Which period we'll call it as the reign of terror? 1793 to 1794. That is the administration of Robespierre. Okay, that time, that during the reign of terror, the new government issued laws ordering closure of women's clubs and banning their political activities. So finally what happened? This, you know, the Robespierre is also representative of Jacobin's club. Yes, very good, children. He's also a representative of political club. So, but when his government came to an, you know, existence, he made a rule that, the women's clubs has to be closed and banned their political activities. Many prominent women were arrested and a number of them executed. So finally what happened? So at that time only, many women leaders, many prominent women, because they had around 60 political clubs. So many of them were arrested and many of them were, a number of them were executed. Executed means even they were killed. Okay, see, women's movements for voting rights and equal wages continued through the next 200 years in many countries of the world. So this we have studied even in the democracy in the contemporary world. Guys, do you remember that? Yes. So what happened? You know, the many countries started to adopt democracy, but still what they were doing? Even though if they adopted the democracy, it was a partial democracy, not complete democracy. The women did not have right to vote. Okay, so that is the reason the many, you know, the countries, the women were struggling for the equal political rights, that is, you know, voting rights along with the equal wages. Even in India, we can see that. Do we see that, you know, the equal wages for the men and women, children? No. So finally what happened? The women started to struggle for the equal wages. You know, it is continued for the next 200 years. Not 1 or 2 years, children. It continued for almost 200 years in the many countries of the world. Okay. See. The fight for the vote was carried out through an international suffrage movement during the late 19th and early 20th century. So it's like the international suffrage movement, the many women around the world, everywhere around the world, in many countries, the women were struggling, or they were fighting against this right. They were expecting this right. They were fighting for the voting right. Okay. So that has carried out through an international suffrage movement during the 19th and even the 20th centuries. Okay. See. The example of the political activities of French women during the revolutionary years was kept alive as an inspiring memory. So it became like a inspiring memory for the whole over the world. The many, so, and we have seen this is a French Revolution as a, you know, the first revolution which has inspired the many countries to fight against this violence or the monarchy and to fight against the dictatorship, and they were expecting for the democracy. Okay, this has inspired the many countries. Okay, see, it was finally in the year of 1946 that women in France won the right to vote. So, almost in the 18th century, they started to struggle for the voting right, but they got in the 20th century, that is in the year of 1946, they got the right to vote. Okay. Guys, hope you guys understood about the concept, right? About women, how they participated in the revolutionary activities and how they were struggling. Okay, so finally, in the first half, what we have seen that? Yes, how women were struggling in the at the time of the French Revolution. So they have to work hard to just to lead their life, and they have to, you know, take care of their family also. They have to help their husbands, you know, even to participate in the revolutionary activities also. Okay, and even though if they are working, they were not getting the equal wages like men. Okay, so that one part we have seen that, and then they were, you know, they started with the political clubs and some newspapers. What was their main idea, children? What was their main demand? Their main demand was political equality like men. Okay, they were expecting the equality, the political equality like men. Okay, that is the voting right. And then what else? Yes, they started with the political, you know, the clubs, around 60 political clubs in the different cities they have started. And then, what else we have studied? Yes, so at the time of Reign of Terror. So, whatever the political clubs they have started, that has been completely banned. And their political activities also completely banned. Okay, so later what happened? They did not have any rights, and the many women, the prominent women who were the part of this activities, the political activities, has been arrested and they were killed also. Okay, but this did not end. Almost 200 years, the women struggled a lot, and even the international women's suffrage movements has been happened just for the, yes, the equal political rights and the equal wages. Okay, so finally in the year of 1946, the women in the France, they won the voting right. Okay, hope you guys understood, right? Yes, children, see. First question, let's go for recapitulation. The first question is, evaluate the role of women in France before the revolution. So before the revolution, how women were struggling, that you have to explain. And then the next question is, how did the women suffer in France during the old regime? So how the women were suffering at the time of old regime, that also you people have to explain. Okay, so guys, we are nearing to the periodic assessment 2, and this time we are just going with the two chapters. One is about French Revolution, and the one more it is, you know, the people as resource. So just go through the concepts in detail. Okay, in detail, and all the best for you all. Study well, don't waste your time, children. Okay, fine. Thank you all. Have a nice day, children.